Hi, Kevin Henry. I'm the editor of Dental Assisting Digest. I'm here with my good friend Teresa Duncan, and we are at the ICOI meeting in conjunction with the ADIA in Chicago. And earlier today, I heard Teresa talk about coding issues and some other things that are going on, so I just thought I'd take a few minutes and talk to her about that, and hopefully we can share some knowledge with you guys. So what are some of the most common questions you hear about when it comes to coding?
Wow. This seems to be an area that not too many people are understanding very well. The reason being is that it's so new, and the codes are just not very clear. Okay. So the bone grafting material, I get a lot of questions about bone grafting, what procedure code to use, and can we charge for the materials? You can charge for the materials. And you also should not be using, I'm going to give you some codes here.
Okay.
You should not be using code D4263 or 4264 for your bone grafting, because that involves a tooth that is still there. It's a periodontally involved tooth, and you can't use that as an implant code. When you're taking out a tooth and bone grafting, you want to use code D7953,
okay,
which is in a totally different code subset, so you want to make sure that you get that right. The other question that I get most often is, what do I use for a pontic?
Okay.
Do I still code the same? Is it still D6240? And the answer is yes. Now, the retainer codes are different because you have to decide whether or not it's an implant or an abutment-supported retainer. Now, you can see why it gets so dry.
Oh, sure.
It gets pretty complicated. But the pontic code is the same.
Okay.
So that's a very common question.
And I know a lot of times, maybe some members of the dental team think, I don't need to know anything about coding. You know, that's somebody else's job.
Mm-hmm.
But you really feel like everybody on the dental team needs to know coding.
I do, Kevin. And the reason is that if they're getting it right in the back, in the front, we're also getting it right. And that increases our reimbursement, basically. I mean, we need to make sure that we're getting paid for the services that we perform. And if we're not coding correctly, the chances of that happening go down to zero. So I think it's important that all team members are at least familiar with the codes, even if it's just a sheet. What I handed out today in mm-hmm. the lecture was just a sheet of the most commonly used codes, and I said to the attendees, just keep a clean copy, laminate it, and, you know, if you need to, take a Sharpie and circle which one you're using. It's as simple as that. So I think it's very important for the whole team to know about implant codes.
I'm going to switch gears on you here a little bit.
Okay.
We were just in Chicago together a couple of weeks ago at Under One Roof.
Yes, great event.
And you did a great job with the oral cancer fundraising.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell the folks who are watching a little bit about that?
This was a passion project of mine. I was so excited to be a part of it. It was a group of hygienists that started off of Amy's List, amyslistrdh.com for anybody who's not already on it. Penwell was so nice to be able to give us a platform. We raised about $1,500, and it's going to all go to the Oral Cancer Foundation. It was phenomenal. A lot of speakers agreed to mention it, and they did, and that raised our raffle sales. It was held at the Career Fusion booth. We had drawings. It was wonderful. We had gift cards to give away. But what was really cool is in the final meeting where they had that, you know, the skit, you were there.
Yes, absolutely.
The last minute, Ann Guignon said, how about raising some more money? Everybody just take some money out of your wallet. And we were able to raise about $500 in less than 20 minutes.
Wow.
That was phenomenal.
That's great.
So I had a blast. DOR was a blast.
Good. Well, be sure to check out Teresa's blog. It's the official blog of the ADIA, and it's at www.thedentalimplantblog.com. And Teresa is great to contribute to a lot of our Penwell publications, including Dental Assisting Digest, and we appreciate that.
Thank you very much, Kevin.
All right. Thanks, Teresa.
All right.